Hello guys, in this video I'm going to walk you through the steps of installing IntelliJ in Ubuntu. And IntelliJ is one of the best IDEs for Java in Ubuntu and even in Windows. So the first thing that you need to do is you need to download Java SDK, which is Java SE download. Java downloads, and then you will choose x64 Debian package for Ubuntu. I've already downloaded mine, so I'm just going to go ahead and install. So go head over to downloads. And the next thing you need to do is you need to download the IntelliJ installation file, IntelliJ IDEA. I like installing the There are two options of installing IntelliJ. One is to install the snap package. Normally it comes in three editions. That is, there is community edition, ultimate, and educational. Normally the one that is free and that I use mostly is IntelliJ community. And if you want to install using snap, you just type sudo snap install IntelliJ IDEA community and then dash dash classic. I'll leave the command in the description also. You just go over to the terminal, control alt, or just search for terminal and start the terminal, and then paste this command, that is sudo snap install IntelliJ IDEA community dash dash classic hyphen classic, and then you press enter. Once you press enter, you'll be prompted to enter your admin password, and from there on it will do the installation for you. Everything will be done. But that is the easiest method, but it consumes a lot of storage. You know, snap packages consume more storage than the traditional apt installer. So I will not install using that method. I'll show you the alternative, which, like I told you, the first thing you need to do is you need to install JDK. And once you've installed the JDK, you will need to download this community edition. This is a compressed file, so you need to download it. And once you've downloaded it, I've already downloaded it. And if you need the link to this page, I also leave in the description. Just download IntelliJ from their official page, and then it is here in the downloads. And then what you need to do is you need to extract. Let me just do it. Extract. I like extracting it. Use that way. Just right clicking and clicking extract. It is entirely up to you to determine where the installation files will sit, but normally they should be in the home folder, and that is where I usually place the directory of my installation files. So ideally, this is how I do it. So I usually move this to the home folder, and let me just do it as you watch. So just move that to home, and then head over to home, and you can see that this folder contains all the installation files for IntelliJ IDEA. So you just rename it. I usually rename it to IDEA, and then open the folder, open the bin folder inside it, and then from while you are inside, just click out of any file here. Just click away, and then once you click away, click open in terminal, and then we should run this IDEA run file. So we should just run it this way. Just type sh idea sh. That's an executable file, so we just run it that way. Yeah, that's the home folder, and then let's just create a new project. And of course, we have already installed an SDK, so Java 17, that is the latest by the time of recording this video. So you should always download the latest SDK unless you need the earlier versions for compatibility issues. And then once you've just chosen the SDK, you need to click next, and then create a command, create project from template, next, and then let's call it tutorial. It's just an example. Click finish. And once you've done that, all you need to do now, the reason why I wanted us to create that project is so that you can also come here in the tools menu and click the tools menu here and click create desktop entry, so that you will not need to run the command every time. So you just click create desktop entry, and then you click create the entry, you check create the entry for all users. It requires super user privileges, so you need your password. Just enter your password. Okay, so from there on, now you are done with the installation. Although Java is still indexing, but if you go to your applications and type IntelliJ, for example, you will see that it is already here. So it is already here. You can just add to your favorites so that you don't need to search for it. Add to your favorites, and then you can see IntelliJ is already installed here. So thanks guys for watching. Please subscribe and like my video. The same procedure applies for installing PyCharm and even Android Studio. So if you guys, because all of them are JetBrains applications, So that is it, guys. See you in the next one. Bye bye.